the wise Ganesha. On the snow-covered mountains of Kailash, there lived Lord Shiva with his wife Parvati. They had two sons, the elder Ganesha and the younger Kartik. Ganesha was wise and patient, while Kartik was playful. But both were very powerful and kind. All the gods loved them dearly. One day, the gods were discussing about the unmatched powers of Ganesha and Kartik. But who was the wiser of the brothers could not be decided. So they approached the holy sage Narada. Sage Narada suggested that they should let the two brothers compete to get their answer. They all reached Mount Kailash and told everything to Shiva and Parvati. It was then decided that the two brothers would race around the world and the one who finished first would be regarded as the wiser of the two. Kartik swiftly started for the race while Ganesha, with his both palms joined in reverence, circled around his parents. When asked what he was doing, he replied, "My parents mean the world to me." Everyone was impressed. When Kartik returned from his journey, he was told everything. He admitted that none was wiser than his brother. And thus, Ganesha won the race and was regarded as the wiser. Dhruva Tara. Once there was a king named Uttanpada. He had two wives, Suniti and Suruchi. Suniti had a son named Dhruva, and Suruchi's son was Uttam. Suruchi hated Dhruva and Suniti and wanted Uttam to be the next king. She was beautiful, so Uttanpada loved her more than Suniti. Under her influence, Uttanpada drove Suniti and Dhruva out of the palace. One day Dhruva went to the palace and saw Uttam sitting on Uttanpada's lap. But when he tried to do the same, Suruchi said, "There is no place for you here." Dhruva looked at his father, but he said nothing. Deeply hurt, Dhruva retired to the forest. He started praying to God. He prayed for several months to please God. Finally, God appeared before him. He granted him not only a place on his father's lap, but also a permanent place in the sky after his death. When this news reached Uttanpada, he was sorry for his actions and brought Dhruva and Suniti back to the palace. Dhruva was made the new king. He ruled for many years. When he died, he became a star called Dhruva Tara, pole star. It is still seen shining in the sky. Wise Bhartari. A long time ago, there lived King Gandharv Sen. He had two wives and two sons, one each from his two wives. Bhartari was the elder son, while Vikramaditya was the younger son. After the death of Gandharv Sen, Bhartari became king. But he soon started losing interest in the welfare of the kingdom. He devoted all his time to the activities of his interest and focused just over himself. So his stepbrother Vikramaditya was seated on the throne soon. One day, Vikramaditya urged him not to neglect his duties. Bhartari got very angry and drove Vikramaditya out of the kingdom and seated himself on the throne. Irritated with his activities, Bhartari's wife deserted him one day. He became very upset and gave up all the pleasures of life. He began leading a holy life and became a devotee of Lord Shiva. He always chanted the name of the Lord. He realized that he had been selfish in thinking only about himself and not about others. He attained complete self-knowledge and became pure at heart. He became one of the most respected sages of India. He is always remembered for his great knowledge and learning. Shankar, the brave boy. Once there lived a king called Jairajan. He was peaceful and loved his kingdom. One day, he found that his relatives were planning to usurp his throne and kill him. To avoid violence, he went to live in a far-off village. There he met a beautiful girl and married her. They started living happily. One day, he saw many human bones on the path of his village. He hurried back home and told everything to his wife. She told that a wicked king was sacrificing young boys to the eagle Garuda. Jayarajan found out that next time a boy named Shankar was to be fed to the eagle. He met Shankar's parents and offered to sacrifice his life instead of Shankar's. They agreed, though Shankar protested. Some days later, Garuda took away Jayarajan. Shankar risked his life and ran to save Jayarajan, but he was killed. When the news reached Shankar's parents, they begged Garuda to leave Jayarajan. Seeing their devotion, Garuda spared Jayarajan's life. Jayarajan now asked Garuda to bring all the dead people back to life. His wish was fulfilled. This way, the sacrifice of brave Shankar saved many precious lives.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.